Good morning, welcome to SSV IIT classes. I am Basha, faculty of maths. We are discussing 8th class analytical geometry. In previous class we discussed about the different forms of straight line. Today we are going to find another form of a straight line, which is in symmetric form and parametric form. So already we discussed normal form and slope intercept form, intercept form with respect to x and y axis. The next one is symmetric form of a line. Already we know the condition, a straight line ax plus by or a plus by plus c is equal to 0, which is in the standard form. We are converting any straight line into symmetric form. Let a line which was passing through x1 y1 and having a slope theta, where theta we have theta is equal to pi by 2, not equal to pi by 2. We have two cases in this section. So equation of straight line passing through x1 by 1 and having slope theta, inclination theta, then slope is equal to m is equal to, let two conditions, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, or we can use tan theta also, the slope of the line. Means equation of line will become y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1 is the equation of a line which was passing through x1 y1 and having slope m. Then from here to we will get y minus y1 is equal to what is m. We can substitute any one of them. So by substituting tan theta x minus x1, then we can write tan as sin theta by cos theta x minus x1. Then substituting separating the terms, we will get into sin theta, it will be y minus y1 by sin theta is equal to x minus x1 by cos theta. So this is the symmetric form of the straight line. We can write it is as by, means it is another form is ratio or fractional form or divisional form. Means we can write as x minus x1 is to cos theta is equal to, I am writing this one, y minus y1 is to sin theta. So this is the symmetric equation of a straight line which was passing through x1 y1 and having inclination theta. And from here, symmetric form of a straight line, there are two cases. If theta is not equal to pi by 2, we will get this condition. Not equal to pi by 2 means x minus x1 is to cos theta is equal to y minus y1 is to sin theta. Case 2, theta is equal to pi by 2 means, observe, cos 90, theta means cos 90 is 0, sin 90 1 means, or we can take here, observe, from here to, by substituting the sin and cos values, means we will get a condition y minus y1 into cos theta is equal to here x minus x1 into sin theta. Theta means pi by 2, y minus y1 into cos pi by 2 is equal to x minus x1 into sin pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 value 0, so 0 into anything 0, LHS will become 0, sin 90 1, x minus x1 into 1, so then x is equal to x1, or x minus x1 is equal to 0 is the equation where the inclination is pi by 2. The next one is the parametric form of a straight line. What is a parametric form? From here, observe, from equation 2, 3, both 1, 2, 3 equations represent the same line. From here to, from equation 2, we are comparing equation 2 as a parameter. Means y minus y1 by sin theta that is equal to x minus x1 by cos theta. This is the symmetric form of a line. I am comparing is equal to r. Let I am taking this equation is equal to r, where r is a parameter, means r belongs to capital R, any real number. So we will find what is the r value also. So from here to, I am comparing first and r, second and r values. Y minus y1 by sin theta is equal to r. Second one is x minus x1 by cos theta is equal to r. Then y minus y1 is equal to r sin theta. Here x minus x1 is equal to r cos theta. Then from here to y is equal to y1 plus r sin theta. from here x is equal to x1 plus r cos theta. So this gives us the parametric form of a straight line. We can write as these two are the parametric form of a straight line. From here to observe these two conditions, x minus x1 is equal to r cos theta 1 here. Next one is y minus y1 is equal to r sin theta. These are the two conditions. I am squaring on both sides. X minus x1 whole square is equal to r square cos square theta. Here also y minus y1 whole square is equal to r square sin square theta. By adding these two conditions, x minus x1 whole square plus y minus y1 whole square is equal to r square cos square theta plus r square sin square theta. By taking r square common, cos square theta plus sin square theta, its value is 1. It is the first trigonometric identity. R square into 1, that is equal to r square. Means by sending a square this side, it will become square root of x minus x1 whole square plus y minus y1 whole square is equal to r, which is the parameter we discussed here. And in this class we discussed two forms of a straight line. One is a symmetric form and the second one is parametric form. The symmetric form of a line is x minus x1 is to cos theta is equal to y minus y1 is to sin theta. And the parametric form of a line is x is equal to x1 plus r cos theta, y is equal to y1 plus r sin theta. And then we are going to discuss about in next class a line or a point which divides the in which form or a point which divides in the which ratio. Thank you.